it's Reagan, and today I am filming my spooktacular TBR, which is essentially October TBR. And October. If you guys haven't already noticed, October for many of people is the month of a theme month. I love October. I love Halloween. I love holidays. I love themes. So this is basically that. So, yes, October is gonna be kind of a theme month. I tried to pick things that were kind of darker in tone, eerier in feeling, and just books I really was looking forward to reading. Before I get started, I will say, the month of October is like exam central. I have so many midterms in the month of October because it's the middle of the semester, so that's just where they all kind of fall, which makes me really sad because obviously I want to read, but I'm hoping that I'll still be able to get quite a bit of reading in, but yes, anyway, let's get started. So the very first book I'm going to show you guys is the book I've already started reading, as it's like, what, the 4th of October at this point? I will say before I tell you the book, it took me so long to figure out what book I wanted to read next, like the first book of October. Like, I wanted something eerie and historical fiction, but like something like that. And then I realized I had a Marcus Sedgwick book on my bookshelf that I hadn't read yet, and so I picked up The Foreshadowing by Marcus Sedgwick. I love his writing. There's something sort of detached and eerie about it that just makes me love it and just like sucks me into the story. This story follows a young girl in World War I, and the chapters are super duper short. I'm almost done. I have like 60 pages left. And it counts down backwards. I don't know what it's counting down to, but I know it's something big. Additionally, it deals with a lot of war during World War I, obviously, and like the death and destruction of it, as well as the main character itself can see when people are going to die. So it's just really spooky, also very, very good. I'm really enjoying it so far, and I can't wait to finish it. The next book I hope to get to this month comes out on the 7th, and I'm sure you all know what it is. It is The Blood of Olympus by Rick Riordan. This is the 5th and final book to the Heroes of Olympus series. It's finally ending. But I cannot wait to read this. I've been anticipating this since I finished House of Hades last year. I've literally been reading Rick Riordan's books every year since 7th grade. So it's been a long journey between him and I. But yes, I hope to read this as soon as I get it. I don't know how long it'll take me to read it because that week and the week after, I have so many exams going on, but I'm hoping I can still read a lot as well. So yes. The next book I hopefully will get to this month is The Evolution of Mara Dyer. This is the second book to the Unbecoming of Mara Dyer series, which I don't want to say much in terms of plot because, I don't know, I don't want to accidentally ruin everything because this book is kind of like a mystery, suspense, psychological thriller YA book, I guess. The narrator is somewhat unreliable and it just makes for a very interesting young adult story. I hear the second one has even more like twists and turns than the first one, as well as the third book comes out in November, so I want to make sure I am up to date on all of the books before the last one comes out, because spoilers is always a fear of mine. The next book I hope to get to is The Whispers of the Fallen by J.D. Netto. This is book one to his book trilogy, I want to say. This was sent to me for review by him, and I just figured this would be a good month to try to read and review it. Yeah, this book is just like a paranormal dystopian angel kind of book. It's very dark, I'm assuming, dealing with things that just are perfect for the month of October. Know what I'm saying? Know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying. Next book is more like a comic compilation. I don't know. I don't think this is a graphic novel, but I don't really know what to call it, so someone help me out. Anyway, I want to read the first volume of Deadly Class. This is a graphic novel that's about kids in an assassin school. It's very violent, very gory. Kind of fits the October theme, I would say. I'm very excited to read this. Plus, I feel like this will be a really fast read that I can get through in a night or two when my busy nights are coming for me. Plus, look, skeletons. Look how Halloween that is. And the last book I really hope I get to finish during the month of October. If not, I will carry it over to the next couple of months. And it is Night Film by Marcia Pessel. This is a murder mystery suspense novel set in modern day. It's centered around a very well-known director who does, like, I think, like, horror movies or something along those lines. Daughter goes missing or is murdered, and they're trying to figure out, like, what happened, who done it, and I just figured it would, you know, it's a very dark toned book and I just figured it would go perfectly for the month of October. You know. Why do I keep doing that? But you know, I'm really excited to read this, so hopefully I get to it this month. So there you go, guys. That is my spooktacular TBR. I hope you guys enjoy. Let me know down below what book you really want to read this month for October that's spooky and scary. I really don't know what I'm doing with my arms right now. Yeah, and I will see you guys soon with another video. Bye!